Hello, happy site owners and webmasters. Man, I'm here with the BlogAid Today live stream on what's new in WordPress 5.3. If you're watching this anywhere other than the BlogAid Facebook page, that's where the live stream is. So if you see me replying to comments and whatever, that's where they are. So be sure that you like, follow, and turn on notifications for the BlogAid Facebook page, because that's where I announce things like this. And do our live stream, especially for Tips Tuesday, our weekly roundup for things too. So, we got a lot going on. I'm going to look over here on my little iPad and get my little post up here so I can see who's here with me and see your questions. Big changes coming to 5.3. And I'll tell you something, this is actually why I've been a little delayed on the Gutenberg updates. Not that I didn't have plenty else going on for it too, you know, to keep me from doing those, but I really wanted to see what was going in 5.3, because we really want to get rid of that Gutenberg plugin. It's a features plugin, and they test everything in it first before it rolls into the core. Well, everything in it up to 6.5 is rolling into the core this time, and woohoo! And I'm sorry it took this long to do it. I never meant for it to have that beta plugin for this long. I put that into my Gutenberg Ninja course to future-proof the course, because changes were coming right in and we needed a couple of those things to do some of the advanced stuff. Well, all that advanced stuff is coming into the core. So as soon as this comes out and we update to it, that's the biggest news that I've got for you, is we can get rid of that plugin if you happen to be using it. I certainly am, because I want some of those extra sorry, I've got a little eyelash or something going on there. Okay. Is it good? Yeah, we're good. extra stuff that plugin had in it. So I am thrilled about this, because I do not want a beta plugin on my site. Hi, Marilyn. Good to see you here. If you're here, say hey to me. So let's go ahead and start jumping in. You're welcome to ask questions too. Now, I've updated this post. I know all of my followers have probably already seen this post. There have been updates because I finally got 5.3 beta 2 on my site. That's why it wasn't updating for me last night when I was talking about it in Tips Tuesday. It was rolling from beta 1 to beta 2. And so I finally got it updated. Hi, Michelle. Good to see you here too. I know there's a lot more peeps here. So let's dive in. You can see the beta 1 release notes. I didn't update that because I didn't realize it was beta 2 yet. We've got more notes, but you can see everything that's going to be in 5.3 even from these notes. Hi, Harriet. Hi, Charlene. Good to see y'all here. So here we are, the block editor improvements, and honey, there are tons of them. I'm so happy about this, I don't know what to do. So a couple of these in particular, I was waiting on for not taking out that plugin, because a lot of us are using the group stuff up here, and then a lot of us are using the column block stuff, more advanced stuff for that. Those are two very super important blocks for you to get styling on, especially the group block is fantastic for nesting other blocks in it, and the whole group block can have styling on it. Very, very important for you on your site. So, hi Tammy, hi Gladys, hi Barb, good to see everybody here with me. And if I don't respond to a question or say hi to you, somebody, you know, somebody else put it in there because I didn't see it. Facebook or my iPad doesn't always show me everything on Facebook. So they've done some more improvements here with the table block, the gallery block. Now listen, there are things that already that you can do with the gallery in Gutenberg that you can't do with the gallery in Classic Editor. And we're very excited about it, because you can put captions with links right on the image, and it's got an opacity behind it. It's the coolest thing. And so they've made a few more things about this with the caption support and different things about it. The separator block has improvements. Now, I'm really looking forward to checking into this, because some of the block suites that I use, they have an amped up separator block. And so you can pick the pixel height and colors and different things with it, have a line in it, different things. So I'm really looking forward to seeing the color support and the different things that's going to be native to Gutenberg too. And then the latest post block improvement, then this acts very much like the latest post widget. And that's a lot of what they've been doing with Gutenberg lately, not only improving Gutenberg, but turning regular WordPress widgets into blocks so that you can use them everywhere. This is fantastic, you know, for different places that you can put it in there. Hi, Penn. Hi, Lanny. Good to see y'all here. So I'm looking forward to seeing that too. And it really cuts down on plugins that you need to do some of these things. Now the list block improvements, this is a big deal because it really should follow how your theme is styled. And there've been a couple of a little bit of conflict or not following your theme style as well as it should with this. So I'm really looking forward to that because it already works, but I want to be able to put it into different themes and have a look at it too to see how it follows the theme styling for lists. You know, even your little bullet point. I have that styled on BlogAid. It's a little, well, you can see it right here. It's a little triangle, a red triangle pointing in. And so I want to make sure that that works for us too. But one of the other really interesting things they're doing with that is this reverse order support. Now, on Heartwood Art, I wanted to show all of the steps in a build plan. And I couldn't do that in a list. Because if I did recent post in that category where it would be in the same thing. Now we can reverse order on it and show it, you know, from the first post down instead of the most recent post down. And so that's kind of cool. So I want to see how this list block is not only going to be used for the list block, but how others are going to adapt it for the different kinds of lists that we can do for like our post and what kind of order we can put them in for latest post or post in a category. So guys, this goes way beyond just what's rolling in decor. That means there's support for it and developers are going to take this and run with it. And let me tell you something. With all this, if you think that Gutenberg is anywhere close to where it was 9 months ago when it was first introduced, you're going to be delightfully surprised. This thing has taken off like a bullet train. Other developers have gotten in on it. It is fantastic. And I've been talking about it a lot in Tips Tuesday and how what I'm going to be doing in the Gutenberg Ninja course is all about these landing pages and the different kinds of things that you need to be able to do. I created a landing page for my Instagram folks. I showed it off in Tips Tuesday last night. You may want to go have a look at that. It's in Tips Tuesday, and we did it in the live stream last night. It took me 3 minutes. No designer would have taken somebody creating a page template with widgets to have done that before, and it took me 3 minutes to do it. And it auto-updates for me. So when somebody looks at a recent post on Instagram, they come over, guess what? It's there, and I don't have to do anything. Yes. So, you know, all these things that you're getting for lead pages, link tree, all these different things, forget about it. Beaver Builder, Elementor, whatever. I have been meeting with my designers and webmasters to show me Beaver Builder and things like that. I have not seen one thing that they're doing that you can't do in Gutenberg now. I kid you not. So I've got a lot of education to do because most people are like, well, I can figure all this out myself. I figured out Gutenberg myself. I have a fully, totally different perspective on that. 80% of clients who came to me for site audit things and whatever, looking at their WordPress stuff, 80% don't know the fundamentals of using WordPress. If you think you've figured out Gutenberg, and everybody in here that's been in the course, they go out to blogging groups and people, I can't do this in Gutenberg, I can't. And she said, man, you know, they tell me, man, they don't even know half of what Gutenberg can do. Come get a course. Use all the power of this thing because it's amazing. And I've already got everything that's in here is already in the course. I'm just going to be updating for what's in the core now, but it's already there. You know, and I might just have to tweak a little something, you know, for how they've enhanced it one little itty-bitty bit, but all of this is already there in the course, including every block that I did to build that Instagram page. So, and now what I'm going to do is go over to all the kinds of landing pages that you need to be able to build, and looking at Astra themes and some of those, you know, something besides Genesis with it too. So it's a big deal with this, and I'm really, 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 really excited about it, too, to share all this with you. Hey, Manny, good to see you. Hi, Gil, good to see you, too. I don't know, but that's a good question, Gil. Do you know if Parallax is doable? I have not checked into any themes yet that have Parallax effect. If y'all wonder what Parallax is, it sits still The image sits still while the page rolls past it. You know, it's kind of almost like a foreground background kind of thing, and the movement is a little different on them. And so I have not reviewed a theme that has parallax on it yet. I know Genesis has some, but I don't think any of those have been updated to be fully Gutenberg compliant. And the only themes that I have reviewed are fully Gutenberg compliant. Now, Gutenberg's going to run on any theme, but the theme may not support all Gutenberg features. And that's what I mean by fully Gutenberg compliant. Here it's saying, I'm in your Goot training. I don't want to have to reinvent the wheel when you nail it for us. Yeah, I know. I'm making it easy. I just take you step by step. Here you go. Boom, there's your whole site. I designed the whole homepage of, well, not the whole thing, but the content area of the homepage in Heartwood Art with Gutenberg. There are no widgets. Yeah, I mean, it's just amazing what you can do with it. So they've also got button block improvements, which is great. I want to see that because some of the more advanced plugin suites, there are other designers, guys. They have just been on a bullet train. They're so far ahead of where WordPress is with Core or even the Gutenberg plugin. And there's all kinds of button stuff in it. Now, if you have a good theme, you're going to have good button support anyway. And there are button blocks if you need more styling options, which is great for your opt-in stuff. Maybe you don't want your default button. All my buttons are red. You can see one up here above my head. My default buttons are red. Maybe I've got an opt-in with a different color. Maybe I want something else. Maybe I want a border around it or so. Maybe I just want to be able to style it myself. And so these more advanced plugins that are kind of, you know, basing everything on the core but giving you more options, this is where WordPress is headed, but we do have it now. And there are 14,000 new block plugins. I'm only including the ones in my course, or only talking about the ones that I think are going to be helpful, because we don't want to go plugin stupid. That's just as bad as getting a theme builder. And there are some plugins that are very advanced, but I know that's at least half of what they have is going to roll into the core. So I'm trying to future-proof us for not being in the same problem we've got now with things like Divi and Thrive Themes and whatever. Those are easy to go into, hard as hell to come out of. Okay? And it's like, but I spent a whole month learning it and designing my site. I want to, yeah, that's the whole problem. And if you do it the Gutenberg way, and I keep you in the safe zone with this, it's going to last you a lot longer and be a lot easier. You know? So we do have to be careful with all the shiny new stuff, you know, because, guys, there's a ton of it. I mean, it's very exciting what you can do. So we have to be a little careful with that. Animations and micro interactions. You can move blocks, the drop downs, and number of small animations to improve it. So, and I saw this, I did a webinar, a private webinar for Gutenberg, and I was building a landing page right in front of him. I said, oh, well, let's do something special, and then let's move this up to the top. And I took that block and put it up there, and I saw their jaws drop. This whole content thing with image, text, opt-in, whatever. Just move it. I don't have to go into the code and redo all. No. You know. So they have some, they've been changing up how this looks, and I'm pretty sure this is going to be improved and tweaked as they hear back from more people about the design aspect and the backside aspect. As a matter of fact, with WordPress 5.3, there's one of those little tweaks, and I'll show that to you in a minute. David's saying, interested to know if any scrolly telling UI have been implemented to Gutenberg. I don't know. I'm thinking, you'll have to tell me what scrolly telly UI is. Sorry, I'm ignorant of that particular lingo. So tell me what that is. Are you talking about that parallax stuff like Gil was? Maybe that. So Manny's saying, I had headway and it was brutal to move to a new theme. Yeah, y'all may remember headway from a long time ago. It was back when Genesis first started. And what was that other one, Manny? There was another one that went bye-bye. Thesis ended up going bye-bye. Honey, let me tell you something. All of these builders, they're on their way. They're not gone. They haven't lost their usefulness. But if they don't adapt to what's going on, they're going to be replaced. And what I'm doing in my course is helping you do just that. And Astra is a big key to this. Not Genesis, Astra. Their themes and their plugins, these people are working directly with me. I've got some improvements for them already. As I dive deeper into this, I'm going to. But I'm going to start talking to people about none of my money-making clients design their own themes, but there are millions of site owners who want to, and they're struggling with Astra, and they're struggling with Gutenberg. You need a course. Don't do all that sweat equity. Come take a course and have fun. And that's one of the things that's going on with this that people are saying, and I talked about that in Tips Tuesday. This is going to bring back more creativity and more individualized webs and whatever, too. It's going to be a lot more fun. And it is. It is a lot more fun. You have a lot more creative control over your site, and you're going to enjoy that for sure. Now, they've also, that's the block part of it. And I wanted to spend a big time on that because there's tons being rolled in, and it's super duper important about these things. And I'll be adding all that to my course, but I'm thrilled with it. David saying scrolly telling. Yeah, parallax. Right. That's the same thing Gil was asking about. I have not reviewed any themes that have parallax in them yet on Goot because, to my knowledge, the Genesis ones are the only ones that I've reviewed, and none of the ones that have parallax on them have been updated. There may be some, but I have not seen any that are fully Gutenberg compliant. Michelle's saying absolutely a lot more fun, and if you look in the comments here, find Michelle Phillips. You will also see posts in the last Tips Tuesdays from her about Astra, because I put it out to all my webmaster designer folks back months ago. Have y'all seen Astra? This looks very impressive. And their speed and Michelle went deep dive head first into it. She's putting out fantastic posts on it. Find her and go have a look. Go back to Tips Tuesday if you want a link. It's Michelle Phillips of Code Fetti. Look at her Astra thing. I've been promoting them like cray cray because they're helping me too, and I appreciate it. And I want you to read them as well. Okay, so Gutenberg performance improvements, this is great. They keep making it faster. Now, there was a really big number in this one. They shaved off 1.5 seconds. And y'all like, well, damn, how slow was it? It's not that slow. You need to vet this against what they say. They're testing a post with 1,000 blocks in it and 36,000 words. That ain't none of us, right? So that's why this 1.5 second thing up here sounds so absolutely dramatic. Well, look what they're testing it against. The main thing is they're concerned about speed, and they've been improving it with every update. Yes, that makes us happy. It's not slow now, okay? So just say, you'll never see on our little post with a couple of thousand words where this ain't, Gutenberg is not going to be our slowdown issue. It's going to be images and different other things, okay? So when you see somebody talking about they shaved off a second and a half, don't worry about it. Okay, accessibility enhancements. Now guys, this is really big. I don't want to spend a lot of time on it, but it's huge. The complaint about Gutenberg was its lack of ADA compliance, Americans with Disabilities Act. And it really, they have a whole team at WordPress that's on top of usability standards like this, and nobody that was developing Gutenberg was listening to them. They were not funding them, they were not supporting them, and the guy that was the head of it finally resigned. He said, I just can't get anywhere. Once we do get the usability stuff in there, the very next update they do, they wipe it out. They're not checking in with us. He resigned. I don't blame him. And the next person down in the thing, remember, a lot of these people are volunteer. She took over. They went out and there was such a stink over this that they went out and got an independent audit for accessibility, and Gutenberg just failed miserably, and they've been working on it ever since, and they're taking this seriously, because last I looked, and I've reported this in Tips Tuesday before, people are getting sued. Now, they're huge people, Beyonce and, I don't know, Kentucky Fried Chicken or something. I mean, they're huge. They're only suing people they think have money. Come on. But people are getting sued because their sites are not accessible. There's even photo heavy gallery kind of sites that are targeted toward images getting sued from the visually impaired. And you think, what? But it's happening and they're getting awarded monetary things. I'm saying, guys, we have to take this seriously. And I'm delighted to see that WordPress is taking this very seriously and doing something about it, and they're continuing to improve this. So it is a really big deal. It's something that you and me need to be aware of. And the other reason I want to mention this is because Gutenberg is going to explode your creativity. We are this close to it being a full theme builder. Now, not necessarily in the WordPress core. That's phase two of Gutenberg, and they're going to be working on that soon. They're already starting the beginnings of it. But honey, the developers, the theme and plugin developers are not waiting. They're already doing it. There's even, you know, page builder themes and what, I mean, they're going over to Goot for some of this stuff. Nobody's waiting on WordPress for this. We are this close. And it is true that it's going to explode your creativity. But there's a reason to pay for a designer and use themes that have a vetted layout that aren't all just pretty. And part of it is this. There are lots of things that a professional designer are going to know that you don't. There's a reason themes are laid out the way they are. You also have page load time issues if you get all cray-cray. Okay? So there's a reason to hire a professional. And it's not just looks. They know tons of things that you don't. Even things up here in the top in your menu with stuff, and you know those little carrots that by menu that lets you know there's a drop down. Most themes use Font Awesome for that little carrot. It brings in a whole library of stuff this big for this one little symbol. No, you get a professional designer no matter what theme you're on. They take that crap out and use dash icons that are natively supported by WordPress instead. Makes a world of difference to your page load time. That one thing. So it's worth it. I want you to play. I want you to come in my course and play to your heart's content. And then I want you to have professional help from a designer to clean up what you don't know and to advise you for that. And you'll save a ton of money and have a lot more fun, probably. But there are still reasons to hire people with this. So keep this in mind. It's not just for disabilities you may not have. It's for your ignorance of what you don't know that could hurt you with this kind of stuff, plus page load. Domino's. Thank you, Dennis. It's Domino's, not Kentucky Fried. Domino's is in court for that. That's who it was. It wasn't. I knew it was a restaurant. Thank you. Yes, and David saying, couldn't be more spot on about the reasons to hire a professional. Absolutely. Because this stuff can bite you in the butt in so many ways that you don't know. And page speed load, responsive for mobile, and not just your phone, because phone sizes come in every kind of different whatever. And then ADA compliant, all kinds of things you don't know. Okay, so go have fun and then have a professional double check you before you release it. That's what I would say. And do the little tweaks you can't do. Because the fun thing about Gutenberg is every one of the blocks has additional CSS. And if you want to make a block that's special for your opt-in or something, you have a designer come in and make that and put that CSS for you. You make a reusable block and call in that little piece of CSS anywhere. Little shadows on the edges of things, you can call that in as a shadow. Any block, anytime, anywhere. But you need a designer to make that for you. See? I mean, you still need designers. I needed one. If I need one, you need one. Okay. All right. So here are all the improvements they're doing. Now, this color and contrast thing, this was really interesting to me. Now, I don't know what this looks like. Some of this is for a screen reader, but I tell you the honest truth, and I'm sorry I forgot to put that in a heading to. But here it is. This is the update if you've already seen this. And guys, I don't know if you can see this on the screen or not. This is so subtle. You'll see it. I noticed it on the login page, you know, the little put in your username and password block. I looked at that and I went, something's different. And then when I got on my dashboard, I went, huh? And I had to open up another site just to check it. And it's like, it is different. It's so subtle, but it's here. And I don't know if you can really see it on this or not, but there's a little more of a shadow and an outline, and the fonts are cleaner. Now, of course, this is a compressed image, but when you log in, when you go to your login page, you'll probably do what I do, and it's sharper. And the modules inside here are sharper, and the fonts are a little sharper in there. So I just wanted to put this in there. I think the login page really shows it more than this does, but it's little shadows in the font, and it's just hard to see, but you'll notice it. So if you'll go, what's that? Something's different, but it's so subtle you won't really know what it is. So there. Okay, now image improvement. So all this is great. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo. You know, let's party, yay. We're getting more powerful and great features in here, and WordPress is caring about the whole world and the community and us, and we're thrilled. Okay, let's go to the flip side of it. I'm not at all thrilled about this at all in any way. Why did they do it? Now you can upload big images. And this is, I have to just quote what they said because y'all are going to go, God. Uploading non-optimized high-resolution pictures from your smartphone isn't a problem anymore. I know every one of my webmasters with clients is falling out on the floor right now. Because you have to bang people on the head to get them to take the time to optimize an image prior to upload. It's what I preach every minute of every day. It's the biggest bang for the buck you can get for page speed. And here's, so what WordPress does, you put this 4,000 by 6,000 image you took on your phone and upload it. And WordPress squishes it and makes it fuzzy. Now the file size is still the same. They just squish the display size. And it's fuzzy. Right? So it says WordPress now supports resuming uploads when they fail, because this thing is so gargantuan big and it can fail in the process. That should be a clue it's too big to upload. Okay. That should be your first clue right there. And it says that way pictures you add from the block editor look their best no matter how people get to your site. I don't even understand the last sentence. Can y'all help me? What does uploading non-optimized high-resolution images from your phone and them having a way to resume the image, how does that, I don't even make the last sentence make any sense to me at all. Maybe I just don't, I'm not reading it right. Y'all help me out. Okay, and what I say about that, I'm just so sorry they're doing it, but you optimize your images prior to upload. I kid you not. Everybody, every site audit client, I've got hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of site audit clients all say the exact same thing. I wish I had found you sooner for things like this, because now they got to go back, or they're paying money for bulk image optimization on their older stuff once they learn how to do it. From there forward, they do it, but they have to pay for getting it done. Honeys, I got you covered either way, but you start doing this. So I want you to jump over to my Helpful Post page, and that's the link that's up here too. And so I want you to jump over there, and in the speed section, I want you to read everything in this speed section. A lot of it has to do with images, and I say how to test your site speed and then how to test just the image optimization. So if you get a new technique, you need to test that it works. Don't assume that it does. Why squish? Is my favorite little, I love this thing. It's fantastic. My buddy and fellow webmaster, Larry Snow, has a fantastic tutorial on YouTube. And I asked if I could embed it. And he said, sure. And it's in here. I couldn't have done it any better myself. And so go look at this and start using Squish. Even if everything is optimized already, even if you put it at 100%, you're going to get that, it'll still squish it some more, and it'll still look fantastic. But you're going to get the newer file formats of like things like MozJPEG. Google's going to love you for that. Okay? And so even Photoshop doesn't have this. It is so quick. So you go through here and you read all the speed stuff because the overwhelming majority of this is about your images. It's that big a bang of a buck for you getting this done. Okay, so I'm not happy at all about this. Let's see. Let me go back here and look at your stuff. Dennis is saying, are they betting that the block usage saves time so that the images can now be bigger? They being WordPress? That's as good a guess as any about what that last, I don't know, I don't understand the last sentence. That's as good a guess as any. David's saying, sounds like an option for non-pro WP users, similar to Squarespace options. Yes, non-pro being the key words. Oof. Barb's saying, file size is so large, internet upload speed can't handle it all at once. Resuming a large file is pretty common. Great to have that option. Dumb to allow full size uploads to begin with on websites, though. There you go. Absolutely. Absolutely. So there's that. Now this, we're going to have to see how this works. Pinterest peeps. Hey. Hey. You need to pay attention to this. Everybody wake up that's on Pinterest, okay? Because this is, we don't know what's going to happen with this. There's a thing out there called XF. I don't know if you can say that, or it's EXIF, but XF orientation process. And it kind of looks at your image and says, no, that should be flipped. Okay. So a lot of folks upload stuff that's landscape, right? Well, the portrait stuff and your longer Pinterest stuff, I hope this thing doesn't mistake it and flip it on you. Right? Because everybody's making those 2x3 ratio Pinterest images now, right? Can we opt out of this? I don't know. I'm not saying it's a problem, but that's the first thing that occurred to me is Pinterest, you know. So y'all let us know. I have not tested it yet. I just, like I said, just got 5.3 on there late last night, early this morning. So I'm going to put a Pinterest image that could go either way that might be iffy and see if this is what this thing does. Now, something that's got a plate on a table, I think it's going to know the food is up, not sideways, you know. But maybe there, I've got a couple of images that could go either way of how I'm putting, on Heartwood Art, how I'm putting a Craig jig thing together, and I've got one that's sideways instead of laying flat, and that one could go either way. I want to see what this thing does and if it freaks out. So if you think you've got some images that might go, now this is just on new stuff, it won't go back and flip old ones, it's just in your upload process, it'll automatically flip things for you. Yee. Maybe you want to create a draft page and try this before, you know, before you make a post with her, say it could get kind of weird on it. So I don't know. We'll see what's going on with that. Just something to watch for. Okay, security. So there's this site health check thing that's actually a thing. It's a standalone outside of WordPress, has nothing to do with them thing. And it comes as a plugin, actually, a big honking thing that does a lot of stuff for you about checking your site's health. And what WordPress is doing is slowly rolling in parts of this thing into the core, which is great, okay? And they had to slow their butts down because people in the cybersecurity community didn't like parts of this and said, well, there's a security, you're putting a security hole in it with this. And so they've slowed down about putting this in there, and it's slowly coming in. So things like if you get the white screen of death, this will help you figure out what the problem was and retain access to your site so you can get in there and fix it. Now, my thing about that is usually that happens on a plugin update. Everything goes squirrely right after an update. Go see my post on the Helpful Post page about how to roll back everything. If you do a plugin update, you do it a very specific way. There's a plugin called WP Rollback, and it's a thing of beauty. It saved my bacon twice. Okay? And so there's a very specific way you need to do your plugin updates with that. And if you get the white screen of death, you still have access to your site. I still prefer that than this, because this is not foolproof. That one is. And so not all plugins participate in it, like premium plugins. There's nothing to roll back to. But any plugin that's in the WordPress repository, there is. But they're rolling more of this stuff in, okay? And so it'll help you with more troubleshooting issues. Now, that said, if you're on SiteGround, they have already closed down some things that are in this because they don't want you to see them because they're handling it their way. In your WP config file, there's a little statement in there for SiteGround WordPress Management System, and it knocks some of this dead already. Forget what's coming in 5.3. It's already there because of the way they have the goofy setup and the way they're doing stuff. I'm not trying to knock SiteGround. I'm trying to tell you it's different. There may be other hosts who are taking the same measures, and they want to, especially managed hosts, and they want to deal with it. And they want to limit what you're seeing through this WordPress core stuff. Or even if you put in the Site Health Check plugin and get that whole shebang, which I don't suggest you do. There's a reason even WordPress is holding off on it. So I'm just saying, hi, Larry. I was just talking about you. So I told everybody to go over and see your squoosh video. So guys, Larry's in here in the comments. Go check him out. So check with your host, and I don't know if you're getting all this. So when you hear rumors about things are happening with this and you're not seeing it, if you have trouble, you need to check with your host. They may be controlling this. It's not going to be the same for everybody. Okay, there's a new email verification. I'm kind of half and half how I feel about this. I saw it though. I logged in and out of my site. When I got 5.3 in there, I logged in and out two or three times because I was looking at this new clarity on some of these things, you know, with the fonts being so clear, and I'd logged in and out, and boom, this popped up the second time that I logged in. So look for this when you do update to 5.3. It may not be the first time you log in, even the second, but by the third time, you'll probably see this. And what it wants you to do is verify your admin or your user email address. If you're logging in as an admin, it wants you to verify your email address. This thing's going to pop up every 6 months. Now, I kind of scratched my head and went, why? I've never had anybody have trouble changing their email address and getting locked out of their site, but none of my people are using their email address as part of their login either. That WordPress leaks the username. Your email address is out on every spam thing in the world. I know, let's not get into it. I know about leaking half your login. I know. I pitched a fit years ago and nobody's listening. Nothing's changing with it. But if you change your email address and you still have that email address, let's say you change your email address to something else and you no longer have access to the old one. But all of your emails inside WordPress for the admin stuff for you it to notify you about things or whatever is still that old address. Uh-oh. So here you have the opportunity. It says update it to something else or this email is correct. Or remind me later on, I won't fool with it. I would just click that this email is correct so it doesn't keep popping up. And it'll come back in 6 months. So it's going to do this every 6 months. I don't know that many people having trouble with it, but I guess it was. I think this is the one that somebody wanted done 9 months or 9 years ago when they finally did it. They said, this ought to be a thing. I don't know. One of these things in here was from 9 years ago. So that was interesting. So don't flip out if, man, what's this? I'm telling you now what it is when you see it. Okay, PHP compatibilities. I'm thrilled for this. Thrilled about this. This is a security and speed thing. So WordPress has never required a minimum PHP version before. 2 years ago, is when they should have started doing this. That's how long, it's almost been 3 years ago that I've been screaming about it and telling people, you need to update your PHP version, right? So, and most of my peeps have. If you haven't, I've got a post for you on how to do that. Okay, the minimum version that you have to be on today is 7.1. Support for it is going to drop December 1st of this year. That's only a few months. I've been talking about it in Tips Tuesday. You need to go on and do that update now. Go all the way up to 7.3 if you can. If that doesn't work, come back to 7.2. But go on and do it now because you may have a plugin or theme or something that's not compatible. You need time to get that fixed before the support drops. So what happens if you don't do it and support drops? Do you leave yourself open for a security hole? That's what. Why would you do that? So don't do that. Okay, so WordPress started out with 5.6 and everybody screamed that that was too low because support's been dead on 5.6 for quite some time. It's a start. And they're trying to get all of the plugin developers. Remember, there are 50,000 something plugins. I'm not kidding. 50,000 something plugins in the WordPress plugins repository. They've got to get all these people up to a minimum level too. And so they took a first step, which I'm happy about. Because support for 7.1 is about to drop, the next recommend they're going to have is for 7.2. So you might as well go up to the highest thing you can that'll hold you for even longer if you can do it. But 7.2 is going to be the minimum. And it won't be around for more than a year because 7.4 is already in the works. They're moving very fast on PHP version changes. That's outside of WordPress. That's WordPress, your plugins, your themes, they're all on the PHP coding language, and it changes, it evolves over time. And we didn't hear about it for a lot of years. We didn't have to worry about it for a lot of years. There's the whole story behind that, and I'll tell you someday. I've told people 2 years ago or 3 years ago when I started talking about it, but it's a thing now, and it's something you got to keep up with. So here's the post on how to check or change your PHP level. It has one for cPanel type host and one for SiteGround as it sits today. And this video will no longer be any good once SiteGround goes over to their new control panel, but I'll make another one, right? But so it's got both ways. And if nothing else, just ask your host, because your host may have their own custom build over cPanel and it doesn't look like this at all, even though it's cPanel. So go ask your host, how is it done? Okay. So either way, you should be able to get some help. 2020 theme, so the new one came out. Yippee-ki-yay, be one more thing for us to delete. You need to think about your themes and your plugins this way. You're in a boat. There's holes all over it. And each one has a cork. Those are your themes and your plugins. If any one of them pops a cork, the whole boat's taking on water. You need to get rid of every theme and every plugin that's not in use. Get rid of the holes. So we're begging them to stop doing this on anything but new installs. They're going, when you do a new install, they install everything from 2020 back to 2011. We're trying to get them to stop doing this on updates, but they're going to do it. You make sure you delete it. And I'll try to remind you to do it. Bug fixes, 400. Bug fixes in 5.3. 400! A lot of these have been long-standing bug fixes. And that's one of the things I'm thrilled to see WordPress dedicated to doing. They have been all year. Well, even since a little bit last year, too. Not just bringing us the new shiny stuff like Gutenberg and other things, but going back and catching all these tickets that have been standing there forever. And bug fixes. And taking care of what we've got, not just what we're going to have. I'm thrilled with their focus on this, thrilled with their focus on PHP minimum versions, all the kinds of stuff they're doing like this. They should have been doing it from the get-go, and I'm glad they're doing it now. And it's going to take time. So, very impressive to see 400 fixes. There are 400,000 more. It's going to take time, but they're doing it, guys. They're doing it. And changing the wheels as we go down the road to give us new stuff, too. So good for them. Okay, so when will it be time to upgrade? We ain't gonna be the first people to do it. They're packing a lot of stuff from a lot of different angles here. It's not just one thing, which is kind of what they did in 5.2. They kind of took a much more narrow focus in 5.2. And it was okay, but not this one. So we won't be the first people to update. Please follow me, Tips Tuesday. I have a post, a podcast, and a live stream for you to keep up with this news. If you sign up for BlogAid News, you will get all my posts, including Tips Tuesday. It'll land right in your inbox. You will never miss anything. And then subscribe to it, iTunes, Stitcher, Google, wherever you listen to your podcast, I am there. And then we do a live stream on Tuesday evenings, which I may be moving the time to winter hours coming up, but right now it's in the evenings. And the time and everything is posted in Tips Tuesday, so go see the post. I ask 15 minutes of you a week to keep you ahead of all these curves. Thank you for giving me that time. So happy to take any questions you've got. Thank you so much for coming to see me live here, and I'll be happy to hang around and answer any questions for you that I can. I haven't poked around in 5.3 a whole lot yet, especially with the Gutenberg. That's what I'm doing this afternoon. I'm going to get started on updating my tutorial, so I'll have more for you. I have not done well with educating on Gutenberg. That's going to change. So my plate's been overly full. I'm coming down to normal again. And so, normal for running my business, and so that's going to change, and I'll have up more posts about educating folks on Gutenberg. Some of my webmaster designer peeps are dragging their feet on it, too, and sticking with the older ways of doing it. It's like, you do know this means the future of your business, right? You know, like in another year or two, you're going to be out of business because everybody's going to want this other thing. They may be poo-pooing it now, but once they see the power of it, and what the shiny new, they're going to want it. And it's your business that's on the line if you don't get up on this. Because these page builders are not going to stay around in the way they are now. And I know people, I respect the fact that they've spent a lot of time learning something. And they can whip out sites faster with what they already know. Well, at some point, that wasn't true either. They had a whole other learning curve. Same thing here. But I have a course. I make it stupid cheap for my webmasters to be in that course because they need it more than anybody. And I want it to be no barrier to entry pricing. I mean, it's insanely cheap for them and to stay in it. So, yes, so Dennis is asking, can we pull 5.3 down to a VM to build local? You can make your whole site. I mean, you can do a local site environment. XAMPP. I haven't done one in a long time because I have a reseller account. I just do my test sites over there. But XAMPP, there's one that's specifically for Mac, MAMP, and it's AMMP, XAMMP. I don't know if, I think it's for Mac and Windows now, but there are others where you can make a local environment. Now, it's going to chew up your disk drive because of the database and stuff. I mean, all this, you got to load in MySQL and everything. It's not just files. You know, you have to have a database and all the other stuff to run it. But you can do that. And a lot of designers that I know, I used to do that too. I used to be a designer. I was more of a coder, developer way back in the day. And I had a local environment to do mine. And it took a chunk out of the disk drive to do it, and it runs at that time it was running in the background all the time, but I think they fixed that because a lot of people are running on a laptop. So you can do a local environment, so there you go. And it's not just Goot 5.3, it's WordPress 5.3, right? Goot is actually at 6.5, the plugin on it's actually version 6.5, but yeah, you can do a local environment. You can also do a sandbox site somewhere else if you want to. The nice folks at Updraft Plus have that. It's Updraft Clone, and it's $15 or something. I have a reseller account, so I can set up new cPanels all the time and do that. David's asking, do you predict the downfall of page builders such as Divi, Beaver, etc. within the next 10 years? 10 years? Two. If that, if they don't evolve. Now, they could do anything. They could evolve and become something else. But I think there's going to be hanger owners for years to come. So they won't entirely go away because their entire client base that they've got now is still going to be out there. And they're still going to want to support it and go their own way with this thing. But I remember Thesis did this. And Manny, you probably know this too. If y'all are from back when and remember Thesis, they did that. And it was, Thesis was a serious contender to Genesis, even more so. It was way before Divi. It's probably where Divi got a lot of their ideas. And Elegant Themes got a lot of their ideas, was from Thesis. But they had a major upgrade to version 2.0, and everybody left. It was horrid. Their user interface was bad. It was harder to use. It was a lot more powerful, but everybody hated it. Some people stuck it out. They hung around for another year or two. But that was it, because everybody poo-pooed it so much, they just lost their base. It was a father and son team, I think, and that was it. Or that was Headway, I think, was a father and son team. Headway went away. So this is not like it's the first time that innovations with WordPress or other competition or whatever has completely decimated sections of the, you know, theme builders and that kind of stuff. There were others before Divi that were huge. Manny can attest to this. He was on Headway, and I'm not sure if he used Thesis, but it was the only way that you could do it yourself. Genesis is still to this day not end user friendly that way. It's really designer focused. Okay, and that's great, and they have great code, but I'm kind of wondering if Genesis is going to stay around. They're behind the times. They're catching up now. But their focus is still where their focus has always been, that you need a designer to handle this. And it's why I'm looking at Astra. Because we've got billions of site owners who want to do something else. And Divi's not good for page speed and whatever, short code, all that stuff coming out of it. Thrive makes beautiful stuff, but same problem. Now, I think there are some things like Elementor. I think it's the best of the best of the best of those things that I have seen. I have not seen them all. I'm way behind the times in seeing them, but I have seen Elementor recently. And one of my webmasters was kind enough to take me through it. I think I know where Gutenberg gets some of their ideas. You know, it's like, wow, this looks a whole lot like, yeah, Elementor looks a whole lot like Gutenberg. It's like, no, Mayanna, Gutenberg looks a whole lot like Elementor. But anyway, Astra Themes, it made their stuff make a lot more sense to me, too, when I saw Elementor. And it's really touted, as far as I know, as some of the best of the best. Now, everybody's got very strong opinions about this. Other people stand up and say, no, Beaver Builder is. And it may be. I haven't seen it in a long time. Last time I saw it, any of these, it was a bloated mess. I've seen Elementor recently. That's why I'm saying that one. And all of these plugin developers that are doing things for, they're so far ahead of WordPress. And what Astra is doing with their themes and their add-ons, plugins for, it's Gutenberg. Oh, it's such a non-lyrical name. Ultimate Add-ons Blocks for Gutenberg. I think that's what it's called. It's so non-lyrical, I can't remember. It's stellar. It's absolutely stellar. There are a few things they can tweak, and I'm certainly going to tell them about that. Genesis went in cahoots with Atomic Blocks, which is owned by Array Themes, and WP Engine bought all of them. So that's why they're in cahoots together. And Atomic Blocks has got a lot of nice things in it too, but they're not focused on speed. They're using things like Font Awesome. And they've got some things that the other ones don't. So, I mean, it really depends on what you need, okay, with that. But all of them, to say this, all of them are so far ahead of WordPress Core. And we're going to have these do-it-yourselfer stuff that Astra is very fast. The speed on it's insane. I'm very impressed with their coding. I'm very impressed with their focus on us, squarely us. And I'm going to help them with that because there is a major learning curve with them too. Michelle's post, you need to go read that. She did a go back two Tips Tuesdays ago, not yesterday's, but the one before. Find the link to Michelle's on AstroTheme. She'll give you a leg up in getting started with it. She's given me a leg up, all of us a leg up in it. And thank you so much, Michelle, for doing that. It's going to help me get started faster. But I see people struggling with it. They struggle with all of them. If you go on to not Fiverr, but some of those freelance sites, and I go in there to see what people are hiring, so I know what to make help for, you know, whatever I can, and tell my webmasters and stuff. So I'm in there. I don't want any of those jobs, but I'm looking. People in there every day. I spent 80 hours on this Divi thing. It's still not like what I want. I need to hire somebody to clean up my mess and make it like what I want. And honestly, they would have been cheaper if they just hired somebody in the first place. And it's that way with a lot of these. And I see people in there. I'm using this builder and I can't figure it out. I've spent all the sweat equity and I'm frustrated. I just need to hire somebody to finish it because they don't understand it would have been cheaper not to have used it and have somebody do it right in the first place. Now they're paying for somebody to clean it up and do it right. It's actually more, and pay for the thing maybe. And it's actually a lot more expensive. So I really think that it's an evolve or die. Another way to look at this, remember, was it Epson printers, dot matrix, remember dot matrix printers? Who was it? Was it Panasonic? There were two or three of them that were big, and I can't remember who it was. It wasn't Brother, because they're still around. But some of these companies are out of the business entirely because they didn't go to inkjet or laser. They stayed with dot matrix, and they died. That was it. And that's the way all of this is, evolve or die. It's that way for us as users. So it's not the right time for some folks to go to Gutenberg, but it is the right time for everybody to start looking at it. And that wasn't true even 6 months ago. It is now. And that's why I released my course. Okie data. Dennis, you must have been around as long as I have. Thank you very much. Okie data, that's who it was. Thank you so much. And they're gone. They're just gone. Where others survived because they adapted. So Gutenberg, no. Is it perfect? No. Does it have every single thing we need to replicate every single thing we do here? No, but there are workarounds. It used to be 6 months ago I was saying, no, it's not time. We're not ready. We are now. And that's why I released my course. All of my students are on it, you know, or they're in the process of flipping over. Some of them are getting theme revamps. Most are not. Now, I didn't even need all of the Gutenberg things for Heartwood Art. I did change themes because my theme was 5 or 6 years old. And it just didn't have some of the features in it, even for Genesis. And things that had rolled into WordPress, it didn't support any of them. It had schema markup, and that was about it. So I needed to change themes no matter what, but I used a hybrid theme. We started with one that still had widgets. And then my designer put everything that was Gutenberg in there, and I'm not using all of it. Like full-width images. I'm not using that on Heartwood Art, but it's there if I want it, you know. So I consider that a hybrid theme because it still has widgets and it's not fully, it's fully compatible, but I'm not using all of it, but it does have widgets. So we're in this funny place. I put out a survey and asked folks, are you going to be changing themes? The majority answer is no. Now, it's a slim majority. It's like 60%, but the answer was no. And people have paid a lot of money for their themes, so they're going to stretch it out. They may not want to use Gutenberg features right now like that. Like, they don't need another template to have the full-width thing or whatever, you know, image. And maybe they're not going to use that. Just like me, I'm not going to use it right this minute. So they're going to try to stretch out. So Beaver Builder and whatever, all of these things are going to be around for a while, probably 3 years. Because they're still going to have users, because people haven't switched totally over yet. When they go for a fully new theme, that may be when they get rid of it. But you know, taking on rebuilding your pages is a big deal. I know, I'm in that boat with it. Heartwood Art, I have started flipping my stuff over. I went back to my page, you know, I'm going back to my pages now for sure. for my post, I have a cutoff line. I want to only go back so far with flipping those over to Gutenberg blocks. And I have a reason for that because of the way I'm going to monetize the site and other things I'm going to do with it. So I have a very specific reason for wanting to do it. Do you have to do that? No. They come in, everything, all your HTML will come into what's called a classic block. It's all there. And you can edit it like you did before. But it's inside a block. And you can put new blocks in there if you want to. So I'm just saying, I have a reason to want to do that because I want to slip blocks into places and I need it broken out. So I'm going to do that. I have a guy that will do it for us, and it's cheap. It's like crazy cheap. And that was one of the reasons I put out that survey. And most people came back and said, no, I can do it myself. Thank you. I'm a DIYer. I take it the people who answered that survey have smaller sites. They're not like me with, 1,500 posts. I don't want to do 1,500 posts. Boy, do I want to pay somebody to do that. When I get to BlogAid, that's exactly what I'll do. I don't think I have 1,500 anymore. I took out, 380 that I took out. So, but still, even 1,000 posts, 1,100 posts, I don't want to do that. I'd rather pay somebody to do that. And I've got a guy. But we're not promoting it just yet because most people answer no. So Dennis is back to 1932. All right. Yeah, you've been around a while, Dennis. Oh. You've seen some things. Okay, so there you go, guys. That's what I've got for you. That's what's going on with this. This is pretty much locked in, I think. I don't think anything's going to come out. Definitely nothing new is going in. They're not looking because it's packed. And unless they find problems. Now, the beta 2 has just come out. And as far as I know, all of this is still in there. If somebody comes up with some egregious something or other, they may pull something out, but I don't think anything new is going to come in. This is not coming out until November. So all of my webmasters, anybody that can test, do it. Now, if you have a production site or whatever in your client, do not test. But my webmasters who can set up test sites and whatever, please help test. See what's going on. See what we're going to run into. I'm going to load up my site with every kind of thing I can think of. All of our common plugins, several different kinds of themes, stuff like that to see what happens with it and try to do my testing and help the community out as well. Plus, there are a few things in here I want to check for us too. So that's what's going on. If there's any more news on it, I'll let you know. But I just wanted to get this out while the news is fresh so you can prepare for it. And also, very seriously, consider getting into the Gutenberg course, Gutenberg Ninja course. Go to BlogAid, look under classes, you'll find it there. And I'm going to be, I've already got everything that's in here is already in there, but boy, am I going even further with it. So now is the time to get on Gutenberg. And you're going to get left behind. Right now, it's easy to learn. After a while, it's going to be a whole lot. And that goes especially for designers. Right now, a lot of people are sharing information. Right now, it's at the beginning stages and it's easy to learn. That's not going to be true in about a year. So get in now if you can. All right, guys, thank you so very much for spending your time with me live today to see what's going on with this. If you're watching this in replay anywhere, do say hi to me and let me know because that lets me know it's important to you. And thank you for supporting all the free and helpful information I make here at BlogAid. And watch Tips Tuesday, be on BlogAid News, and I'll let you know when it's time to update with it. All right, have a good day. I'll see you online.